That is their issue, man. Seriously, I think you know, मियाँ बीवी राजी तो क्या करेगा काजी? Actually, if the first Mrs. Khan was, the first Mrs. Khan says in, I mean, in fact, in a really path-breaking interview given to Shashikala Baliga, of who was then with Society, the three of them talked about this moment, and the first Mrs. Khan, who is Salman Khan's mother, said that you know, it wasn't easy and that there was a lot of pain, but eventually they got to know each other and they got to appreciate each other, and they're now perfectly happy. And hey, if they're happy, you know, there's very little happiness in the world. It's good that they're happy.
Helen, as an icon, as an idol, for anyone,
means kya kahun? She is. Helen is an icon. She's an idol. She, you see, I think there are stars. You know, like for instance, if you think about it, Rajesh Khanna was a star, a big, very big star. K.L. Sehgal was a very big star. And, but that's what they were stars. They didn't become anything else. Rajesh Khanna stopped being important by 1981. Look at Helen, look at Amitabh Bachchan, they reinvent themselves. There's a constant need for them at a certain level. We need to have them around. And those are that's what separates the icons from the stars. Amazing, no? Yeah. I mean, old man is still there, beard, bald, ganja, everything, but still the crows will roll in. Go figure, man, seriously. Kuch achha kiya hoga pichle janam mein, something like that. Must be. And she had a huge amount of suffering. There's a point at which she goes bankrupt and all, no? P.N. Arora vanishes with all her money, she has to go off to the Dadas, and she goes to Dilip Kumar and says, you know, please intervene. Dilip Kumar sends off to Haji Mastan. Haji Mastan goes and intervenes, gets some money back from P.N. Arora. It's not an easy life, yeah. It's horrid times, I think. And you read her early memories, where she talks about running away from Burma, where she talks about how they had to go to the when they came to live in Bandra, they lived in a house that was so bad that when she went to the toilet, she had to carry an umbrella because rats and cockroaches would fall on her. This is not fun. Yeah. So, if she's having a good time now and, you know, she's settled down into respectability, into iconhood, into being someone whom you would like to make films about, that's great for her. She's paid her chips. How does she do that? You'll have to ask her, no? See, I'm not sure exactly what, when you talk about a fantasy figure, no? It becomes, what you do with fantasy is you abstract certain elements of it. And you say that, okay, it's that moment in that song that really interests me and that is what I'm going to play with. Now, what you are doing, when anyone becomes a fantasy figure, that abstraction is out of their control. What happens is out of their control. You have no idea where it will go inside people's heads. But I think what does remain is that sense of affection that people had for her. And I think that is almost as valuable a part of the Helen magic as anything else. Yeah?
It's in your research, you did see that, you know, how she came about to this, to the position that she came into. She had been through, it has been difficult for her.
Oh, I think, you know, there is a whole category of people in the film industry called strugglers. So, sangharsh to karna hi padta hai. I think that is written into the stars. As soon as you start is line mein, as they all say, is line mein. I think only star children don't struggle. Everybody else struggles. That's why there's a category called struggler in the film industry. Is line mein, you know, you have to struggle. So, I think Helen certainly paid her way. I think every one of those, you know, she did not build up iconship, she did not build up her position as an idol overnight. It was the slow accretion of memory that we all have, that of this song, of that particular ada, that little nakhra, that little twitch of the hand, you know, all these things add up in a little way to a huge sense of that, of that cargo of delight that she brings with her. Thank you.
Yeah.